Hello, everybody, and welcome to Austrian Adventures. It's Captain Kevin. Check out my YouTube channel for the rest of the videos. This is number 4 in a series of 7. Today it's Zell and Kitzbühl, and then Kufstein. Here's the route. That stop in Zell will be an overnight. And away we go, starting at the Salzburg airport. LOWS is the ICAO designation, and SZG would be your bag tag, or the IATA designation. Thrust maximum. And away we go. Keep it straight. Today's flight is going to be towards the more towards the west and southwest of Salzburg than previous flights. Really looking forward to the Kitzbühel area. But we'll do some scenic. Okay, let's pay attention here, Kevin. Keep it straight. This is a little squirrely, this airplane, sometimes. I got to make sure I got it going straight. Okay, there's the 50 knots. We can fly now 60 knots, nose up. Come on, baby. Come on, little Icon E5, and wheels are up. There goes the gear going up. Flaps going up. And we made it. This is Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. As I mentioned, the aircraft's now Icon A5, amphibian, so we can land on water, we can land on a river, we can land on, of course, an airport. Oh, look at that Untersburg off in the background. Gorgeous. Salzburg Airport. And away we go. We're heading now towards the southwest. This is the village of Valls, just right by the airport. And following the A1, the Autobahn in Austria, and off to the right is Munich. If you went another 2 hours by car, you'd be in Munich, off to the right-hand side there by their Autobahn. A few little villages along the way we'll point out as we go. Hitting. Here we are at 3,000 feet. Seems to be a good altitude. Looking for this little valley straight ahead of us near Bad Reichenhall. Here we go. Going to pick up the Solach River. That's the one that flows into the Salzach, and should be starting just about here at the Salzach Say. And there is the valley that we're looking for. Going to be a very, very visual flight today. Right, little left. I have the video set to 4x the speed, so we're doing approximately, almost 400 knots. Unterjettenberg, Jettenberg, a little village below. Which way do we go now? Let's have a look. I got a mountain up ahead. And left turn looks in order. Here we go. And continue down the river. Beautiful day for flying. Clear skies almost. In the shadow of the mountains even. Here's a, of course, the highway all the way along here. Niederland, another village. And then the river and the valley itself. Check my map, so, to make sure that I know what the, if there's any mountain passes, what minimum altitude I need. So I'm going to be okay at 3,000 for sure. Fairly wide valley here. Looks like it's opening up straight ahead and slightly to the left. So that's probably where we're headed. Here's the river below. First stop will be at Zell am See Airport, Flughafen, village of Lofer. I've never driven this way in a car before, so this is all new to me. Looks like it'll be an easy drive with the valley as wide as it is, following the river. Another village. Saint Martin by Lofer. Right. There's a right turn and a left turn coming up. I can see the road. Here we go, right into the sun. Oh, there's the sun. See how it really blinds you in the valley a little bit. Wouldn't want to do this in bad weather, of course. Dreispach. Dreispach. How's my Austrian, my German? I'm working on it. Oh, it's getting a little steeper, the canyon here. No problem for us. Looks a little industrial as we went by what looked like an open pit mine of some kind.
Salzburg Tower, Healy 101, frequency change.
So the village, Vandelhof. Vandelhof. There's more industrial on the left. Oh, the valley is open wide. Now again we have to choose. It looks like we'll follow to the right. That's the river I can see going to the right. Oh, and way up ahead. It might even be the lake. Let's have a look. There's your wide valley that we popped out into at Saalfelden. Good-sized town, I want to go visit that. Yes, we'll do that next time. Next time I get to Austria. This is December 2020 during the pandemic. So I'm at home filming this, wishing I was here. We have a home away from home in Salzburg, and we'll get back there soon. There is a lake coming up ahead. First, go over the village of Bad Hausfeld. And the Zellertsee. Say the German word for lake. And there's a town called Zellertsee. It should be right under the nose. That means we're also close to an airport, so I gotta think about getting ready for a landing. I know the airport's just off to the right a little bit. Got it in sight. Flugplatz. Flying right overhead. There it is. Nice view from the overhead view. Left turn to a downwind leg. We fly a box around the airport. Allows us to get our speed back. Get our gear and flaps as needed. Here's the base leg, it's called. Airport's off the left wing tip. I'll be turning another left turn in. There, go down, gear down. Left turn. On final. Power back. And we were starting down for the landing. Keep it straight. LOWZ is the international identifier for the airport. Okay, Kevin, power off. Hold it off. Nose up a little. You can do it. Yeah, good. Oh, okay. Whoa! Get it back to the center line. Get it back. Oh, this is a little squirrely, this airplane, this little amphibian. It doesn't take much. We got it. We're under control. Okay. Center line. Yeah, finally. Okay, let's taxi that in. Parking to the right, I believe. Yeah, we'll go to the right main terminal. With Microsoft Flight Simulator, they made an enhanced airport here at Zellertsee so that the aircraft and the hangars should look a little bit better than the normal airports, the average airport that's just very basically modeled in computer graphic imagery. This one's modeled a little bit better. One of the reasons I wanted to come here and check out this airport. See what kind of planes and hangar facilities they have. There's a nice looking tower off to the right. So I'll take a moment for the taxi. Helicopter on the left. Yeah, helicopter on the left. Another one. Pretty good looking fuel stand on the left as well. Tower straight ahead, slightly left. Off to the right, a line of aircraft. We'll look for a hangar because we're going to stop overnight here at Zellertsee. Grab a taxi, see if we can find a Gasthof and a fine Austrian meal. I wonder, let's see. Because in the morning, we'll be departing for Kitzbühel. And a special visit of Kitzbühel. Oh, nice looking hangar there. Fire station. Okay, we'll park in front of this hangar. Big left turn. It looks like a crew is there to wait on us. looks like a Cessna 206, maybe a 208 off to the right. We'll pull in front of his hangar door. There we go, folks. Zeller and Say. Let's get that engine off. He salutes me, I salute him. And let's go find a dinner.
Ambiente, some wohlfühl.
Oh, there it is. Look at this restaurant. Okay. Ah, that looks typical. Oh, schnitzel. Kartoffel. Yeah, okay. We're back in the hangar, 12 hours from bottle to throttle. This is the route for the rest of the flight. Ending in Kufstein today. There's our little icon A5. We'll get that out of the hangar in a moment. And away we go. Beautiful little airplane. Wouldn't mind having one of those myself. Hangar doors are opening. Let's drag it out. Okay, away we go. We're on the runway. 2470 feet is the field elevation, it says. My altimeter is a little bit out. Lower right corner is the altimeter. 2480 max thrust. Keep it straight. Let's see if I can do better on takeoff than I did on landing. That was squirrely. There we go. That's it. 40 knots, I can see. Goes up. We got the speed. And we're airborne. Gear up selected. Here it comes. Flaps up selected. Here it comes. And we're going to do a straight-out departure. We're flying west, due west for a while, before we'll swing to the north towards Kitzbühel. There's the sun's beautiful view from behind. Keep it straight. I'm at approaching 3,000 feet. Might need a little higher. The pass going to Kitzbühel is a bit higher than that. But here we go at four times the speed as we've done before. Enjoy the view. Wide valley here. Flying the roads as we always do. This is highway number 168. And of course, over the villages, I'll point them out to you. Utendorf, like a valley off to the left there. Stufelden. This valley going west eventually ends in essentially a box canyon. You have to go up fairly high to get over it and continue on westerly direction towards eventually towards Switzerland. Here comes a Mittersill, and this is a checkpoint for me because this is where we have to leave that valley and start turning towards the north. I'm going to pick up this new highway 161, which is a little curvy, and I'm now at 3,700 feet. Try to get above this rise. And pretty soon, there we go. We'll make the turn towards the right, or towards the north momentarily. Following the road. Looking for the valley. I think this is it here. See it making its turn. And to Kitzbühel. Okay, let's go. I'm up and now at 4,500 feet, and that should do it. I think that's going to be our altitude for the rest of the way. We'll see. I'll settle in around there if I can. Jokbergwald is my best guess. Ostach, another village as we go by along the highway. This is going to be a treat when we get to Kitzbühel. I've been there once before by car during the summertime. Of course, this is summertime in this particular simulator version. I set it up so that we could have the best view of the mountain, even though I'm filming in December 2020, as I mentioned before. I've got this set up as if it was in May. I wanted to have a good summertime view of the mountain. Although, it's a ski hill area, maybe I should have set it up for the winter. Village of Kitzbühel, straight ahead, big wide valley, and on the left, by the left wingtip, will be the mountain called Hahnenkamm. Yeah, the site of some fantastic, probably the world's greatest ski race, the downhill, the Hahnenkamm. Let's check it out. Big wide valley, so a nice space to turn around. There's the Hahnenkamm on the left. I'm going to need about 6,000 feet to get to the top of the Hahnenkamm where the racers first start downhill. That's up around the 6,000 foot mark. So we'll work up that high a little bit as we go off to the mountain. Trees will be blocking lots of the ski slopes or the trails, or the stripe as it's called. But there I am, still climbing up. I just get it up. There we go to the top. And that's at 6,700 feet. So there's this hut here, and this is where the downhill would start. Right about here, they'll start the downhill race. World Cup downhill, greatest race in ski. And here, boy, 1 minute and 50 seconds, you're at the bottom. Not sure if I can fly down it, but I'll kind of gear down. We'll increase our descent rate, and we'll just fly down the hill a little bit. Pretend we're on skis. Pretend we're one of those crazy Canucks. Working our way down. I can't go down as fast as this hill is going. There's the village below. Cable car runs, of course, taking skiers up. And off to the left, that's the Hahnenkamm. They do both the downhill and giant slalom. Slalom, obviously, the World Cup races from there. Little flight over the village. Let's call it a city, it's good size. This Kitzbühel is much like many other. Oh, here we go. Listen, look at this. Sit back and watch. Wow, there's an example of how steep it is. And look at this. The crazy Canucks, I remember this well from the 1980s. What a ski team that was. It's said that you can win the World Cup of Skiing after winning 16 races or so around the world, but once you win the downhill at Kitzbühel on the Hahnenkamm, you're a legend. And of course we had our winners. Kitzbühel is a fantastic resort for the rich and famous. Let's leave that behind us. Carry on north, Highway 161. Let's work our way up towards another village in the north. Let's see. Not too far away is Kufstein on the River Inn. So we'll follow a few of the valleys and see if we can find out what the village Kufstein looks like. Of course, these rivers are historical trading routes. Romans in particular used all these river valleys to find their way across the Alps to Austria, Germany beyond. And these villages all spotted over all trading villages, thousands of years old. Here we go. Working our way now towards the west as we turned a little bit to the left or to the west. Bare mountain tops, as you can see, because they're all up around 6,000, 7,000, 8,000 feet, some of them. Very lush valleys. Schattensight. That's my German, Schattensight. Okay, we'll work off to the right of that unique looking mountain on Highway 173. I know where that's taking us. That'll get us to where we're going. This valley leads to the Inn River, and its valley, the Inn River, is a major river running through Austria, obviously from Innsbruck all the way down to the Danube. And on this Inn River, we should see around the corner here a city, an old city. Yes, indeed, there it is, Kufstein. Right on the river with a great castle. Of course, the castle was there to protect the trade. Wouldn't get past that castle unless you paid the ferryman. As goods were flowing both directions on this river. Yeah, it does go to Innsbruck. Listen. One of my favorite German television shows, the Rosenheim Cops. That's how I learned my language a little bit. Just for fun, I threw that in. Okay, that's Kufstein. Let's find a spot to land. Checked it out earlier. There's a small little airport. Never seen it before, but here we go. It's a grass strip. Okay, turning final. I see it. The power back. The Flugplatz Kufstein Lang. Kampfen. Grass. Okay, straight up. Watch your speed. Bring your nose up, hold it there, wait for it. Speed slowing down, aircraft slowing itself, and touchdown. Set the brakes. Turn it around and taxi back. There you have it, folks. Salzburg to Zell am See overnight. Enjoyed a great meal. Visit to the Hahnenkamm down the hill. Go Canada. And here we are in Kufstein. We'll park here overnight and invite you to visit our next flight in these Austrian adventures. Here's my series of flights. This is number 4, Zell am See, Kitzbühl, Kufstein. Next one, Kufstein to Innsbruck. I hope you come along and check that one out.